This part of the review of the Project Manager plugin function will be devoted to the Models tab. I talked about the context menu in the second part of the review, so I will not talk about it now. I will talk about the functions that have not yet been considered, the context menu of the Project Manager. At the moment, such functions are available: New Catalog, Add Folder, Refresh, and Paste. The New Catalog function creates a virtual folder that exists without being attached to the real location on the hard drive. That is, you can create several thematic directories in which folders with your 3D content will be placed. But at the same time, folders can be duplicated in different virtual directories. For example, the directory Seating contains all the furniture on which you can sit, with the exception of sofas. For them, there is its own directory and sorting system. In the Seating directory, there is a folder with the kids' chairs. I can duplicate this folder in a new directory in which you can collect all 3D content for the children's room, toys, beds, chairs. Since I've had my own directory system for a long time, I will simply copy the folders from one directory to another. I create a directory. And just copy or drag the necessary folders. Another way to fill the directories is by adding folders from Windows Explorer, or by direct dragging from the Windows Explorer window. Thus, it is possible to organize several directories with different subject selections for the situation and fill in folders with the relevant content. But at the same time, there are no duplicate folders on the hard disk. To organize the directories, there are functions: copy, cut, and paste. I will remind you one more time that only the shortcuts, not physical folders, copy. You can remove a shortcut to a folder using Remove Folder function. Here is the option: Remove Folder from Models category. At the same time, the folder is not deleted from the hard disk or the network or network storage. You can delete the physical folder using the option Delete from the hard drive. I will not do this, but there is this function here. To change the location of a folder or a directory, you can use functions: Move to top level, Move above, and Move below. Besides additional functions, there is an option: Add to batch, Render and relink. Using it, you can send a folder or a directory straight to the task of Batch Render and Relink utility, which I talked about in the first part of the review. Reveal in Windows Explorer. The Reveal in Windows Explorer function opens the physical location of the folder. Work in the main window of the plugin. The following functions are available in the top panel of the section: Opening the model in a third-party program installed on the computer. For example, I can open OBJ or FBX format in Deep Exploration program. The list of programs is automatically updated when you find the desired program through the Open With menu. Next comes the navigation buttons for the directories, history, and refresh button. then the address line of the physical directory placement. Through which you can also surf the directories. Even if you haven't added them to the Project Manager. Content in directory can be filtered by type of format if you leave the checkboxes only on the necessary extensions. Or by file name if you enter a keyword in the search bar. You can also set the search logic by setting the required function and, or advanced. I'll skip ahead and add the following information to the search topic. To any files, you can attach comments and tags that greatly expand the search function. I have not done this yet, but for the review, I made a test and assigned the tag red to a number of files in the seeding directory. You can do it in the Information tab. Choose a file, assign a tag or commentary. I will use a tag. Add the tag red. That's it. Next, you need to enable the tag search option. Go to the directory seeding and check how it works. I type the word red and click Start. Now I've got on my screen only the models that have the tag red attached to them. This is a simple but powerful tool that lets you assign additional attributes that make searching for content in the directory simpler. With these functions, you can divide the models by style. For example, classic, modern, ethno, etc. Or you can write information about the finishing materials, color, shape of the 3D object, or the functional purpose of the room where this object can be placed. For example, bedroom, children's room, bank, hospital, beauty salon, etc. Yes, it is laborious work, but if you plan to stay in visualization for more than 1 year, it will be justified. In addition, there is no need to attribution in one sitting. You can slowly, in the process of operation, add the necessary attributes with which you are working at the moment. Above the main window of the directory, where the content is displayed, there is a functional panel with the following tools. The Replace Section function replaces the selected object or group of objects in the scene. When you click the menu Replace Selection, a dialog window appears. I have already talked about it in the previous reviews. Now, just by default, I will replace all objects. This happens very quickly, which is very convenient for the selection of the particular model if there is any need for it. Another option allows you to change objects inside a scene. We pick the object, choose the menu, replace section with picked object, and pick the object. The window appears again. In this way, the selected object was changed. The next window, Save, Export Selected, saves the selected object in the scene. It creates a draft preview and saves its textures into a separate folder. For example, I will add this chair into the scene. you can imagine a situation when you model something inside a scene. We are only interested in this chair. We select it and activate the option Save Export Selected. The window Save Export Selected appears. What's in it for us? It gives us the possibility to name the object. Decide what the save folder will be and select the option Save Bitmaps. Save Screenshot. And a version. Here we choose either the 3D Max version or an additional format in which our models need to be saved. 17th 3D Max allows you to save it at least in the 2014th version. Now I choose the folder. For the experiment, I created a temporary folder. Click Save. That's it. In this folder, a model. A preview to it. And also the textures to this model. It is very simple and convenient to add this or that model from the scene to the library through this function and collect all the necessary textures to it. You can customize the Tools panel through Custom Menu and then Customize Menu and Toolbar. The tools on the right configure the display options for the model preview in the directory and the sorting options. Just to increase the size of the preview or change it to three possible types, large, preview, and information. There is also sorting by name, size of the file, type of the file, and the date of change. Well, this is the usual standard sorting kit. Now I will talk about all the possible options of import, export, and opening 3D models via the Project Manager. Through the Content menu, I can open the scene in the program's current window or a new window. The function, Open with Associated Application, also here are options. I have already mentioned this menu. I will not talk about it in details. Merge menu adds a model into the current scene through standard 3D's Max dialog. There is also a possibility to add a model as a XREF scene. Through the Exports to menu, you can convert any model into the needed format. This contemplates the context menu options, but there are other options for adding a 3D model to the scene. For example, double-click with the left mouse button adds the model to the scene. You can also drag the model into the scene and put it into the needed place. When you activate Place Options tab, I have already activated Place Options tab. By default, it looks like this. If you activate by mouse click and select Place on Scene Objects, then you have the possibility to place the model in the other objects in the scene. For example, you can hang the mirrors on the wall, put a dinner set on the table, and place the chairs on the floor. And not only the floor, the objects are connected with regard to normals. In the Settings tab, you can customize merge options. Among the obvious options, there are excluding splines, hidden or frozen objects and cameras. You can also set the necessary type of objects that you do not want to add to the scene with the selected model. You can set the mode when the geometry is automatically transferred to the proxy. Before this, you just need to activate the checkbox and choose the necessary proxy type. The proxy will be added without dialog windows of creating proxy. Just by default. The proxy file is automatically created inside the source folder. If I update the directory now, I'll see the new proxy file. To avoid problems with materials that are already in the scene, there is Auto Rename Merged Materials. But if you wish, you can install alternative options. Use Scene Material and Use Merged Material. Let's go back to Information tab. In this tab, there is the main information about the file and its content. If you click Manage Asset Files, you will see the textures in the model file. For example, this chair. At the moment, the texture status is missing, but if you click Start, then there will be an automatic search. And when you click Apply Changes and Close, the updated texture paths information will be recorded. In this menu, without opening the scene file, you can find and transfer all files associated with the selected model. That's all for today. Have fast renders. See you.